Now,
just a few seconds ago, though, on Christmas Rockefeller Center. Now, this young lady, I don't know her name or background or much about her, but she did a different version of Run, Run, Rudolph. But like I said, they let her do it that way, you know. See, the thing is, if you're good, have a good ear,
I know,
you can sing anything you hear.
Right.
Now, she was kind of doing Run, Run, Rudolph, Santa, bring your presents to town. Right? The original song. But she was also adding some, like, woo, 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 and things like that.
Right, you know, right.
And they were playing it with a little bit more percussions, a little bit more, less instrumentation, too.
Right, you know.
But, yeah. I only heard it once, right? I mean, right. You know, like I said, but it sounded good, right? You know what I mean? But I can learn the song, right, and sing it back to you.
Right.
And then teach others how to sing it, too.
Right.
That's the other part of copyright law you're not allowing us to do, which is legal.
Right.
So you can't not, if we're outside your system, right, we can't afford to get in, stop us from teaching your music.
Right.
Especially if you're putting it out in the public, right?
Yeah.
See, what you don't understand is public domain,
right,
is anything you let the public hear for free.
Right.
But you can't take it back like you didn't put it out there for free. Do you know what I mean?
Right.
For one, you're putting it on the radio. If it's the public radio, you can listen to it.
Right.
Though if you want to hear a specific song, you either got to do what? Buy the CD or wait till it comes around on radio and get drowned around, around. Yeah, that's what it sounds like. That's
right.
Yeah, somebody does.
Right.
But it's in the loop. And like I said, you can even play this song on 98.7 The River now because it's doing Christmas songs.
Right.
But again, I'm not the DJ. Right. I'm not working for the radio station. But if you send the video to one of the people who are, they play it. They play it. I thought it was a good version. And it kind of beats Chubby Checker's version. Right? But again, I'm not saying nothing about it. Right? But again, that's what I'm trying to offer you too. But it's like, here's your situation, right? This part of copyright law says this, but this part of copyright law says you can't abuse it either, right? See, what you're doing is you got all the rights to your music, yes, but it's music. Music can be taught,
right?
Educationally, right? And you're not allowing the educational part of the music to be taught,
right?
For free.
For free.
And you're getting mad about it. You want money about it you don't get,
right?
Because I'm teaching you music for free.
Right.
Even if I should get a salary for it, which, you know, I'm a music teacher, kind of trying to be that, right? But I don't have the credentials yet,
right?
You know how that is, too, right? All these accusations ain't helping on that. All this bullshit I'm dealing with ain't happening on that,
right?
But I'm still showing you how to do shit you should be blowing your mind I can do,
right?
If I'm as bad as they say I am, right, how about pulling all this rabbit out the hat,
right?
But I can't make you even listen to one of my videos,
right?
But I gotta listen to your crap whether I like it or not,
right?
Which I'm saying crap as in your stuff, not saying it's bad, but it can get crappy. If I can't do it legally,
right,
which is the point of fair use,
right,
so I can do it legally,
right,
without stepping on your toes. I give you credit as the artist,
right?
That's how that's supposed to work. Now, let's say I'm painting a painting, and it's by Leonardo, Da Vinci,
right,
and I'm doing something based on his work,
right?
Am I saying if I do his work, I'm Leonardo da Vinci? No. But I am, right, able to draw to the standard that I can match his artwork, right? If I was to do something like that. But is that copyright infringement, or do I have the same eye as Leonardo, right, and himself, right? And, okay, he painted it first, right? I get that. But it don't stem my painting ability if I can do the same thing, does it? And teach others to paint like him too, right? Right. That's the whole thing about singing a song, right? Imitation, not mocking you, unless I'm doing it as a parody, which a parody... Immockable, can't live without you. But that's kind of a parody, right? But I can sound a little like him too, yeah. You don't hear it? Then I can't make you hear it. Either, right? But I hear it. And I'm just trying to have fun with you people. Oh, no. I don't know what the hell y'all do, right? I don't know if it's something good or something bad, but I know you're breaching all the rules to do it, right? Yes, you are. Right. If no one can sing your song in public, even for free, you're going too far with copyright law. You don't really understand it, right? No, you don't. And there's pros and cons to everything, right? In other words, there's a good way to do copyright law, but there's also a bad way to do it, right? If you're doing it the bad way, you won't even let someone sample your stuff, even a little bit. Even if it was originally in public domain and you use it in a movie, right? Do you still get it that it's still in public domain, right? Well, even if they did it like in Sister Act 2, right? Remember when the girl seen Mary had a little lamb and all that, right? Right. Well, anyone, legally, right, you can't steal that song out of public domain because no one really owns it, right, and put it in a movie, and then now say you got the copyright on that movie, on that song, right? You can't do it because that's a song everyone can sing, right, while it's in public domain, right, and you can't take it out of public domain, right? And we'll ruin it for someone else who wants to sing it too, right? Whoopee. I don't know you, but anyone can mistake signals, right? Even she did it with me if she let me pull her panties down. You get it? Right. We were on two different levels, and she didn't say she was waiting for marriage, and I would have waited if she said that. I usually do that anyway. That's called a failure to communicate what you wanted, whether it was just oral or real sex, right? And she didn't specify either, right? And she let me. See, I was also taught, if you don't say no, it's consent, right? I mean, yeah. Before you have sex, right? If you're doing the moves, and she's letting you do the moves, and she ain't told you she's waiting for marriage. You don't know, right? And she has to tell you that, right? That's what I was taught, right? Right. Yeah. Right. And if you don't tell me that, I can't read your mind to know what your thoughts are. But we're making out, honey. I'm trying to make love to the girl, right? She's let me go down on her almost, right? When we get to the ship. So what does she think I'm after? Patty cake? To just lick her? No. I never gave her that impression. No, I don't think. I did anyway. And she didn't say she was late for marriage, right? See, you got to tell me that. I'm not a mind reader just because you go out to church. I don't know what kind of Christian you are. You could be in the paradox like I was, right? My pastor was trying to jerk off with us. You get it? And the pastors under him was trying to talk us into it, right? Yeah. Well, that's kind of messed up if that's your own pastor. And then I meet you afterwards, right? I don't know what your church believes. Like, I didn't know what his believed when I first went out there, right? I thought they were teaching me Jesus too, but then he started getting all Jim Josie on me and I kept going out eventually, right? But they had to make a move on me three times before I was sure they were into it, right? Three strikes, you're out, right? Just like men, right? Three strikes, he's out, right? You asking me if I'm gay, and I'm saying no, right? But then, honey, I read the scripture about Moses saying laying with a virgin. I'm the one treating you like the virgin, honey. I'm honoring you to wait for marriage from you, right? That's what it means if you have premarital sex. To Moses, right? You understand, right? If you do it, you're supposed to get married, right? You're the one who broke off the engagement before you got married, right? All I can do is say, okay, bye, right? Eventually, I know, after 9 months of trying to figure out what the hell's going on with you, right, I had to let you go and move on to Daphne. Though I moved on when I got back to the damn port, right? I started to be with other women, right? But I at least gave you till that time when we went to other ports before you got back home, right? I met you, like, very quickly on the damn tour anyway, right, of the Mediterranean. That's what it is. The ship goes to the Mediterranean as a part of its patrol, right? And this was our second tour, right? And it might have even been your first, like I said. But see, when your prophetess warns you, you're behaving more like the prodigal daughter than the prodigal son. I was behaving like, right? See, we're both prodigal children in that situation there, right? Your problem is you didn't think you had to tell me you were waiting for marriage when you did. I didn't know that, right? I'm not a mind reader, right? And you're supposed to tell the man, right? You're waiting for marriage. You damn sure don't let him pull it out of your panties if you haven't told him that, right? He's going to think you're into it, right? You got to do that up front. Up front. If I'm making out with you, most women who are waiting for marriage use this song. Don't hit me in the eyes, keep on using yourself, right? That's from the damn song, right? Most people know about, right? Even in the church, right? Right. If I'm making out with a church girl, the church girl's the one being the little dipshits, right? Usually too, right? Mm-hmm. She has to tell me no, right? And if she don't, she's letting me do it, right?
Right.
Even if it was a church girl, right? And she's letting me kiss on her, and she don't tell me no, right? I'm doing what I want to do with her, and she's letting me, right? That's consent, right? Too, I know. Another way of consenting is to let the person do what they want to do to you until they complete what they're doing with you, right? If you're doing that, you're going on with the flow, right? Not against it, right? Until you acted weird months later, right? It wasn't even immediately. You just quit writing me when I started getting more personal about getting married, even if I didn't get you pregnant and things like that, right? Well, who do you think you are, Miss Saint, right? You're a woman and not God. So am I a man and not God. You got to tell me what you want, or don't want. I don't know the day of if you're interacting with me to that point, right? And you didn't listen to her. I keep telling you that, dude. If your prophetess told you to beware of me and you didn't beware of me, you let it happen, what does that mean for me, right? I used you or you used me, right? I was on a different path than you anyway, in the Bible, right? I knew Moses said what he said about it already. Because I'd done read through it a few times and Christian Fellowship Church was showing me different things already, right? And their take on the Bible was different than what I was taught in the South, which had to do with the Trinity, right? Okay, as Pentecostals, we believe either in the Trinity or oneness, right? Meaning Jesus is the sole image of God and no one else, right? And God the Father is the Spirit, and God the Son, the Holy Ghost is the Spirit, and Jesus is the mediator between us all, right? Basically, he's the one between us, right? That's why we're one in this Pentecostal. And there's one God and one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus, right? It ain't simple as that, you know, he's just an insignificant little person, right? Who don't matter. He matters, right? Mm-hmm. Nas taught everything you believe, though, too. She learned. And more and more. Because I'm also trying to figure out what's going on with us in the church today, right? Since the dream, too, right? Now, you don't know all the details about my life, right? I don't know all the details about yours, right? But all we are two prodigal children who hooked up once, right? That's it. You're both the prodigal daughter, and I'm the prodigal son, right? And Jesus is our mediator between God and men, right? Even if we don't all understand it, right? But all you can really do is forgive each other our trespasses. I'm confessing I was confused and why? What are you doing? Not saying a damn thing, acting all self-righteous, and what can I do about that either? Forgive you, right? I don't know what's wrong with you. I know. I was taught to communicate and forget not with such sacrifices God is well pleased, right? I'm trying to talk to you like a human being would talk to another human being who's confused about what the hell's going on with her life, right? And I'm confused about what's going on in my life, right? And I'm telling you more things that I couldn't tell you now than I'm telling you then, right? Than what I was telling you then, dude, right? You didn't know all this. I didn't know all whatever's going on with your life still, right? Why you're acting so weird, right? I just knew what I had to do with your dad. Well, you're not the only girl I dealt with who was having problems with her dad that way, right? You're around a few girls, right? Now, here's the problem, right? If you are acting sarcastic, right? Do you tell somebody you were molested by your dad anyway? So, no. Not normally. That ain't something you normally bring up in conversation, right? And what am I supposed to do if he did forgive you? Right. It's not your fault. Right. You whatever the hell's going on, right? You didn't know what you were doing. He's taking advantage of his own daughter. That's crazy, right? That's worse than Lot and his daughter, because they're the daughters are being the crazy ones and having to get their dad all drunk like Bill and Keenan, right? And him walking in on them, right? And Keenan being cursed for all that nonsense, right? Because he's the one naked in the tent with his grandfather. That ain't necessarily kosher, right? He didn't curse any of the other children him had either. Just one man. Young man, he's a grandson, right? But still, he's with his grandfather drunk in the tent with him, right? This is what the story's really telling you if you read it between the lines, too, right? It's telling you something went on between Noah and his grandson that wasn't supposed to go on, right? Okay? It's naming, he didn't curse him, he cursed Canaan right away, right? Who was also the one in the land, I know, Abraham was promised too, right? Before the Jews got there, right? It had something to do with all that too, right? Right. And he was to be made a servant of servants and all that, right? But again, sometimes that could be the devil trying to get you at each other's throats, right? The simplest thing to do there wasn't for Noah to curse his grandson because they were both drunk, right? It don't mean the grandson was acting any less drunk than the grandfather, right? That's forgiveness of it, by the way. You see what I mean, right? Both were drunk, both were in the tent naked. Ham saw his grandson with his own son with his grandfather, with his own father, right? And he was freaking out and went and told the brothers, right? And Canaan got cursed for it, right? I know. This is the real gist of the story, that right? What I'm trying to say, though, is both men were intoxicated. Neither man was acting as themselves normally. So let it go. Forgive it, right? Ain't that best? Ain't that best. Right? Let it go. If you don't love me, set me free, right? Why don't you, babe? Get out of my life, why don't you, babe? You don't really love me, you're just keeping me hanging on, right? Yes, you are. You never knew me, right? That's what Jesus is saying to a lot of us, right? You don't know my real spirit. You're more satanic, right? Then you're not forgiving the trespass of others that you help them do with you, right? No one can get you alone unless you go off with them, right? No one can get you undressed unless you want to do something a little sexual. And you never said there was a boundary of those acts, right? Unless you thought you were with a woman. I know I don't look like no damn woman. Not at 23. Unless you were really blind with those glasses. And that's a joke. Hello? I'm joking with you, right? I mean, I know I look like another woman in there, but I mean, come on, even now, right? I'm still a man, honey. There ain't no women on the side pan, right? Whatever you're thinking there. Unless you just thought I was a small-breasted European woman, right? I'm not. I'm not even an A cup then, right?